In this video, we're going to investigate into some properties of optical fiber. Optical fiber was invented by Charles Kao. But do you know what optical fiber is? Actually, it is an idea of using light to send messages. In our daily life, messages can be sent to computers with a fast speed. We can browse the internet and chat with the others with immediate response just because of the use of optical fiber. Talking about the operation of optical fiber, in the center, it has a core. Around the core is a layer called the cladding. The core and the cladding are made of different kinds of glass and plastic, so that light travels lower in the core than it does in the cladding. If the light in the core hits the edge of the cladding at a shallow angle, it bounces off. Light can travel inside the core and bounce off of the cladding. No light escapes until it comes to the end of the fiber, unless the fiber is bent or stretched. If the cladding of the fiber is stretched, it may break. A plastic coating called the buffer covers the cladding to protect it. Often, the buffered fiber is put inside an even tougher layer called the jacket. This makes it easy to use the fiber without breaking it. Secondly, we're going to talk about the advantages of using optical fiber. Comparing with other traditional materials just like copper wire, there are many advantages for using optical fiber. The information carrying capacity of a transmission system is directly proportional to the carrier frequency of the transmitted signal. The optical carrier frequency is in the range of 1014 Hz, while the radio frequency is about 106 Hz. Plus, the optical fibers have enormous transmission bandwidth and high data rate. Using wavelength division multiplexing operation, the data rate or information carrying capacity of optical fibers is enhanced to many orders of magnitude. Optical fiber also has lower transmission loss, immunity to crosstalk, electrical isolation, smaller size and weight, signal security, more ruggedness and flexibility, lower cost, higher availability, and finally, reliability. There are three main sources of loss in optical signals. They are intrinsic loss in the materials itself, such as infrared absorption, extrinsic loss due to impurity ions, and scattering loss due to structure non-uniformity. The high loss was mainly due to impurity in the glass, the noise due to the loss, and the attenuation due to the long distance travel increased the data transmission error. We can reduce the error by optical modulation. Modulation of a continuous light beam removes the laser diode related problems at a cost of greater complexity. It also eliminates the signal to noise problems of applying a modulated subcarrier. The stable light source allows maximum transmission distance for a given amount of dispersion in the fiber. Established methods include delivering the data to electrically modulated crystalline materials such as lithium niobate. These devices can rapidly switch the light beam between a direct signal path or split the beam into two paths with 180 degrees phase shift, which cancel when combined. This provides electrically controlled on-off transmission that do not affect the light source. The difficulty of modulation is to control the phase and amplitude of the combined light waves to be constructive and destructive interfered with each other. In conclusion, it is used as an instrument in microsurgery to project images from inside the body and help surgeons see in heart to reach places in modern day. It is also used while in communication, both in computer networks as a fast internet connection source and in telecommunication, both transcontinentally and transoceanically.